These paintings are the expression of 50 prominent artists across the country. Their art is being showcased at the Museum Gallery in Kala Ghoda in Mumbai to raise funds for patients of breast cancer. This charity art show conducted by Dr. Khubchandani, a victim of breast cancer herself, saw a sale of 35% of the paintings on the very first day. But it's more than charity that's a trigger for art sales these days. In the last few years, collectors have also started investing in art.
It's an important form of investment, but it requires knowledge, it requires taste.
While the trend is catching up, the debate is still out on whether art should be perceived as an object of investment or appreciated for its artistic value.
It's a bubble right now. We don't know when it's going to burst, so might as well make the use, you know, best use of it. But I would buy art because I like the work.
But for me, it's not about selling. There's no way I would sell art.
Even dedicated art investors maintain that the initial urge to buy will always be the love for art. But those keen on investing know that a good piece of work will eventually yield returns.
Increasingly, of course, people are looking at art purely as an investment, like they would property or they would do with shares. But I think that's still in the minority. People still tend to like art and buy it, knowing that it is not consumption expenditure, but is also likely to appreciate.
Experts also feel that the art market in India, after an initial boom, has now settled. And it's the long-term investor with an eye for quality who ends up with the best bet. Gone are the days when art was purchased merely for the love of it. Today, it's also about buying the right art at the right price. But the verdict on what finally can make art sell could sway either way. Ranak Kotecha, NewsX, Mumbai.